In this video, I'm gonna give you a quick overview on the core functionalities of Google Tag Manager, why it's such an awesome tool to use for your tracking deployment, and how you can utilize it to level up your analytics. All and more coming up. Hey there, and welcome back to another video of measureschool.com, teaching you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian. On this channel, we do marketing tech reviews, tutorials, and tips and tricks videos around analytics and tracking. So if you haven't yet, consider subscribing down below. Now it's 2019, and I wanted to redo our very popular Google Tag Manager for Beginners series. In this first lesson, we're gonna talk about the core functionalities and I give you a quick overview on what Google Tag Manager is all about. If you want to test your knowledge at the end of this video, then I have a quiz prepared for you. You can head over to measureschool.com/lesson1 and fill out this quiz, and I'm gonna give you results later on and some more resources. But for now, we got lots to cover, so let's dive in. Welcome to Google Tag Manager. Now, before we dive into the interface and what you can do here, let's first define the problem that Google Tag Manager helps us to solve. So let's say you have a website where you want to extend the functionality via third-party tools, such as tracking tools like Google Analytics, or do advertising like on Facebook ads. Oftentimes, these tools ask you to install tracking code onto your page. And these tracking codes look a little bit like this. These are JavaScript codes and also oftentimes referred to in marketing terms as marketing tags. And you see them quite often with third-party tools. So for example, here Google Analytics has its tag, Facebook has its tag with the Facebook pixel, or Google Ads also asks you to install its tag to your page. To install them, most of the times they ask you to place the codes in the head section of the HTML of your page. What does that mean? Well, I have a little example here where we have our tags already installed and we can view the HTML code by right-clicking and viewing page source. So here's the HTML document. And if we scroll down, we can see that we already have our tags installed here. Right here, we have our Google tags and then we have our Facebook pixel. And this is where you would normally place your tags. Now we can see that these tags are correctly installed with the help of the extensions, the Google Tag Assistant. So here we see we have our Google Ads remarketing and our Google Analytics. And we also have our Facebook Pixel Helper extension, which shows us that the Facebook pixel is deployed correctly. Now, how does Google Tag Manager fit into all of this? Well, let's take a look at an example where I have Google Tag Manager deployed. As we can see in the Tag Assistant, we still have Google Analytics deployed and the remarketing, additionally Google Tag Manager, and the Facebook Pixel Helper tells us that the Facebook pixel has been deployed correctly. The difference is when we look into the view page source here, that we can't find our tracking codes nowhere, except of the Google Tag Manager code. And this is a tag in itself. This is the Google Tag Manager container snippet, which is placed on this website. And this is what Google Tag Manager at its core really does. You get one central Google Tag Manager snippet that you install onto your page, and henceforth, you can control and deploy tags through a central management console. And this is this interface. So when we go over to tags here, we can see the different codes that we have installed. And if you use a tag template, we don't actually have to mess with any kind of these codes here, but it gives you a graphical user interface where you can configure everything and see how everything is configured. Now, as the name implies, from this central tool, we can manage all our different codes, implement them, but also see what is installed under which circumstances. And Google Tag Manager comes with a heap of useful tools. For example, the preview mode. If I click this button here, it will put my browser and only my browser into a special state, which allows me on my website where I have Google Tag Manager installed to see a preview window down here, which gives me more information of which tags have been deployed on this particular page view. So I go over to the next page. I see again which tags have been deployed. Now, these seem to be always the same, and that's because I attached a trigger, which is like a rule, to these tags
to tell them when they should be deployed. And in our case, that would be the all pages trigger. So I want to fire these tags on all the pages that the users visits on our website. But Google Tag Manager is actually very well equipped to fire tags under specific circumstances that you define. So as an example here, let's fire a tag when the user clicks on this add to cart button. And that's really the power of Google Tag Manager, because we can define triggers to fire on interactions such as a button click or a scroll on our website. So let's define here a new tag. This will be a Google Analytics event tag for our add to cart click. As a tag configuration, we'll just choose our tool here. I will choose the track type event. Don't worry if you don't understand what I'm doing right here. We'll explain this in later lessons. And now I can define my firing trigger. For that, I will go onto the triggers that I have available, and I'm going to define a new trigger. This will be a click trigger for our add to cart button. And I have a host of different interactions that I can choose. You see, we have element visibility, form submission, scroll depth, and so on. But we want to go with a click trigger where we can choose under which conditions this should fire. In our case, it would be the click text, and I want it to contain add to cart. Let's save this. And now it's attached to our tag and see if this works. Let's save this. And this again, when the power of the preview mode comes in, we can refresh this. And now we're going to try it out by clicking on our add to cart button. And we see that our Google Analytics event tag has fired. And when we go over to Google Analytics, let's go into the real-time reporting and see under our events. It was received right here by Google Analytics as well. So really easily you can set up interaction-based tracking with the help of Google Tag Manager without actually going through the exercise of coding anything up, just through this central management console. Now this tracking itself is not yet live on the website. It happens only on my browser, because what Google Tag Manager has built in is a preview system, which we have used with our preview console down here, and then a version control system. So in order to deploy this tracking to all our users who visit the website, we need to submit this as a version. So we click here on the submit button. You can name your versions and then publish them to all your users. And at that moment, it will become live on your website. And this is a best practice system, because Google Tag Manager actually keeps track of the versions that have been deployed. So at any time, if you find that your tracking is not working anymore or a mistake has been made, you can easily roll back to a prior version where your tracking was working correctly. In that regard, Google Tag Manager is really an awesome tool for handling your marketing tags efficiently through this central management console and simply deploying your tags faster, because you just have one central snippet that all your tags go through.
All right, so there you have it, a quick overview on the core functionalities of Google Tag Manager. Did you understand everything? Well, if you want to test your knowledge, head over to measureschool.com/lesson1, where I have a little bit of a quiz prepared for you that you can go through, and then you'll get your results and see where you can improve. And if you want to learn more about Google Tag Manager, stick around, subscribe to our channel right over there, because we bring you new videos just like this one and our next lesson just next week. And if it's already there, you can click right over there as well. As always, my name is Julian. Till next time.